Suppose you have a productivity series controller with a high-speed output module that's driving a stepper drive, which is controlling a stepper motor, and that stepper motor isn't reacting to the commands you're sending it from the ladder code in the controller. With so many active components in the chain, where do you start when the motor doesn't react to those commands you sent from the ladder code? Is it your code, or is it one of the electronic components? Debugging problems like this can be time-consuming and expensive. The good news is, the Productivity Suite software has a tool that makes debugging this stuff so easy. Let's set up a new project. Choose a CPU. We're using the one connected to the USB port. This CPU is brand new. It has no project in it. With the CPU in stop mode, go to the System Configuration and auto detect all the hardware. Double click on that, and we see that we have a Productivity 2000 controller with two high-speed output cards in its base, one in slot 1 and one in slot 2. Great. We selected the CPU and auto-detected the hardware. We have no code in the CPU, and we haven't configured the HSO modules. We've just detected the hardware. That's it. Given that, check this out. Under the Tools menu, there's a High-Speed Output Module testing tool. It's also over here under Monitor and Debug. This tool gives me complete control over the HSO module, and it's completely independent of the ladder code in the controller and the module's configuration, neither of which we've done yet. Here are my two modules, the one in slot 1 and one in slot 2. Let's test the slot 1 module. To do that, click on Start Monitoring. The module has two high-speed output channels. I have a motor connected to channel 1, so we'll play with that one. My stepper drive is set to 2,000 pulses per revolution. So if we send 20,000 pulses per second, the slide screw should turn at 10 times per second. And since the screw's pitch is 0.5 inches per revolution, we'll expect to see 5 inches of travel per second. Let's accelerate and decelerate at twice that rate. The system is wired for pulse and direction, and I have the carriage set in the center of the slide, so I don't care which direction we start with. Now if I hit start, I instantly see the carriage ramp up to speed and move at 5 inches per second. Perfect. And remember, we did all of this completely independent of any PLC code or high-speed output module configuration. So if the motor does move as expected, we know our issue is back here. If the motor doesn't move, the issue is over here. This tool just cut the scope of our debug problem in half, and it tells us exactly where we need to be focusing our attention, hardware or software. And since we have complete control over the pulses generated, we can also use it to verify that we have the stepper drive configured correctly. And by playing with this, I can instantly see that positive direction means the slide moves to the right, and negative direction is to the left. Another time saver. I don't have to figure it out. I just try it and see the answer. What happens if I put zero acceleration in here? Well, nothing. Why? Because we told it not to ramp up to speed. Makes sense, right? What happens if we put a low value in for acceleration? Well, it takes forever to ramp up to speed. The stop button will ramp down at the deceleration rate, and the abort button stops everything dead in its tracks immediately. The beauty of this tool is you can play with the motion system and get a feel for how it's going to react to commands before you write your first line of ladder code or even configure the module. So now, when you do write your ladder code, you know exactly what to expect, and you know you have functioning hardware. And that makes your life so much easier. Also, since the HSO modules always maintain real-time position and real-time velocity information independent of the processor, you can see those actual values while you're testing. You can also monitor all the HSO modules' discrete inputs and even manipulate all of the outputs. Again, independent of the code in the processor. So, the bottom line is, this tool gives you complete control over the entire HSO module independent of the rest of the project, so you can set up and test your hardware before writing your first line of code, which makes you more productive, which is why we call it the Productivity Family of Controllers. If you need any help, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.